What's going on, everybody? Adam here with E-Trailer. Today, we're gonna be taking a look at the Swagman XP5 on our 2017 Jeep Cherokee. This is gonna be a great rack for getting the whole family's bikes on. What you need is a class 3 hitch or higher, and this is gonna be able to go on your vehicle, but also a motorhome as well, which is always a plus. We're gonna have 5 cradles here, and we're gonna have a 35 pounds per bike capacity on the cradles, but the bike rack as a whole is going to have a 100 pound capacity, so we can put 5 20 pound bikes on here. But if you have one that's over 20 pounds, then we're not really going to be able to use that. Just make sure that all of your bikes together are going to be under that 100 pounds. This isn't going to be great for your carbon fiber bikes, as we do have frame contact, but these cradles are pretty nice for getting it super secured down. As you can see, we have these little knobs, and the nice thing about it is we're going to be able to accept frame widths or diameters up to 2 inches. And the way we can do that is there's different slots. We have 3 slots here. So for the bigger bikes, we're going to put it up on top. And then for the smaller ones, of course, we're just going to put them down at the bottom. So that's always nice, just to have different ways of getting the best fit for your vehicle, or for your bikes, excuse me. But another thing that we can do, if you have an odd shaped frame, maybe it's a little curved or something like that, whenever we do put these on, you can tilt them right or left and make it to where it fits that bike perfectly. Let's go ahead and take this bike off the rack. It's the same thing as I did right up here. You just need to take these knob and loosen that up. And as you saw before, they do not attach, so you are gonna have to put them somewhere whenever you're getting your bike off the rack. They come off pretty quickly because they're not a nylon lock nut, so that's always a good thing. We can take this, put it somewhere for now. I'll put it in my pocket. And then you can go ahead and take the bike off the rack. And now we can get a closer look at the cradles. So there is a nice little padding on there. So there's a padding on the top and the bottom, and they are gonna have these little fins at the bottom, and that's gonna be for your bike cables so they're not smashing up against your frame. And then we go ahead and replace these. One thing that is different between the cradles, they're pretty much all universal, and you can space them apart whatever you see is fit. I put them pretty much universal, about 5 inches from each to the other one, but you can spread them out a little bit more. Maybe some you want a little bit closer, some a little bit wider. It all just depends on the setup you're wanting to go with. The back one here is one that you're going to want to put the heaviest bikes of all of them. And the difference between this back cradle compared to all the others is this little plate. So this plate on the back is for this little strap that comes with the kit. It'll hook in here, and you'll take that down and loop it through your hitch loops and tighten it down. So that's just gonna minimize the amount of movement that you have. You don't have to use it, but if you see a little bit more movement than you want, you can use this little bracket to help that. And the only other different cradle is gonna be the front one. The only difference between this one and the rest is just the knob. So there's gonna be a locking knob right here. We will get 2 keys with our kit, and that's nice because if this bike is locked to the rack, all the other ones are gonna be locked as well. So that's always a plus. It comes with it. You don't have to buy it separately. With any hitch mounted accessory, we're gonna add a little bit of length to the back of the vehicle, and from about right here to the farthest point is gonna be about 32 inches. And we are going to be able to have a tilting feature. So with the tilting feature, what we want to do is pull this pin out. And once we get that done, go ahead and kind of lift it up a little bit, and then it'll tilt away. So then we can go ahead and access the back. We checked and we don't have any clearance issues, which is always a plus. So you don't have to take this out every single time just to access whatever you have in the back, and then put it back up. We do want to make sure to wiggle it to make sure that these studs fit in the little groove the best they can. And then if you get it lined up right, that pin will go right through and you can replace it. It does come with an anti-rattle bolt, which does not come with this locking core. You can buy it separately. I recommend doing that because if we're locking our bikes to the rack, might as well lock the rack to the hitch. This way, if someone really wants to get aggressive with it and manhandle the whole entire rack with all the bikes, with the lock on there, you're not gonna have that issue, which is always a plus. And again, the anti-rattle bolt is gonna make it nice and secure to the hitch, so you're not gonna see a whole lot of shaking in your rear view mirror, and you're not gonna hear it either, and your bikes aren't gonna feel it. So that's always a plus. Again, this was the Swagman XP. It's really for the people who really wanna bring a lot of bikes. If you got a lot of friends or just a lot of people in your family, if it's growing family, this is gonna be a great option for you. Again, Swagman XP on our 2017 Jeep Cherokee.